Welcome, distinguished guests, faculty, students, members of the academic community, and visitors to the University of Chicago. It is an honor to have you among us for today's panel. My name is Al-Arian, and I am currently a student in the college at the University of Chicago. Before we begin, I have the honor of introducing our event and moderator for the evening. One of the most vexing questions facing any movement seeking to reshape or overthrow an existing political order is what means should be utilized to attain its goals. Outside observers tend to approach the question through the lens of their own prior ideological commitments, often ignoring the contextual paradigm in which this decision must be made. That is, what means are most viable for a particular faction in a particular situation. Further complicating the issue is that modern resistance movements are increasingly moving from isolated incidents of popular rebellion to becoming fronts within global ideological struggles and international geopolitics. With the prevalence of intersecting theoretical frameworks such as liberalism, political religion, and nationalism, resistance to existing orders often comes into conflict with the interests of state power, forcing nations to choose which movements to tolerate and which to castrate. From early modern revolutions in the context of Enlightenment ideals to the colonial rebellions of the age of imperialism, to the more contemporary struggles for self-determination in areas such as Ireland, India, Palestine, and even the equal rights movements throughout the United States and the Western world under the shadow of the Cold War, one can see the consistent strain on resistance movements to balance its domestic agenda with the external pressures of international politics. Ironically, despite the popular iconography of our age, even the struggle for American independence was no less determined by the rivalry of empires. From a nonviolent movement of colonial subjects opposing policies of their imperial masters, the American cause was brought to fruition not merely by the sacrifices of citizen soldiers, but through the political ambition and ideological sentiments of the Kingdom of France and its military prowess. In short, the central dilemma of any resistance movement has often been, as Malcolm X said, a choice between the ballot or the bullet. This evening's panel aims to explore this phenomenon, to illuminate the frameworks in which political and social resistance operate, to track the perilous path of resistance within the struggle of nations and ideologies, and to lay out the possibilities in which future movements will have to operate. The panel will begin with a discussion of the philosophical foundations of social and political resistance, exploring the fundamental question of how passive discontent towards a particular socio-political order, such as the neoliberal paradigm we currently face, can rapidly form